I've done a lot of projects using round-shaped aquariums over the past 6 years or so, all shown in hundreds of videos. Here you can see some of my old aquariums. Many times I've been asked by different viewers if it is possible to scale whatever I've been doing to a large normal box-shaped aquariums. I like and I do all I can natural, round forms are the most natural. And I always set up aquariums of a particular size for each particular project. So, finally, you can see my cube-shaped aquarium that I set up for 3 major projects. First of all, to check and answer the question you've been asking. It is a sustainable aquarium where I've been testing a working prototype of a self-feeding setup shown in previous video. And in this cube aquarium, I don't put any land plants on top as I've done in all my other aquariums. The third major long-term project is to learn more about antlers' behavior. And there is a long list of minor projects for this cube. Now let me show you the setup of this cube tank. I found a plexiglass cube-shaped box. Each side of the box is about 20 cm long. So it is suitable for up to 6 cm long fish. A family of about 3 cm long antlers should feel comfortable in an aquarium this size. I already prepared a piece of plexiglass to use as a cover to reduce water evaporation. I put 3 different types of gravel in this aquarium. Let's arrange gravel by color in some triangular shapes. Here I add imaginary blue and white gravel. And some rusty brownish gravel goes on the right side. It all looks pretty cool to me. Now let's add some seashells. Colorful sea glass and marbles looks nice in the aquarium. Add whatever decorations you like. I put a lot of shiny treasures in this tank. Add dechlorinated water. I prefer to add aged algae-rich water. Aquatic creatures and fish feed on common green algae, and algae feeds on waste dissolved in water. To make space for my new cube aquarium, I disassembled one of my old 3-liter jar aquariums. So, let's reuse the water from the old aquarium as well. And there are ramshorn snails, guppy grass and marima balls. And I put all the waste from the old aquarium in the cube as well. I don't change water in my aquariums at all. So it comes with all the bacteria, sea shrimp and who knows what else accumulated in the past years. 6 liters of water fits in this cube tank. I keep all my aquariums with fish on a shelf next to the southern window away from direct sunlight. It can take a day or so for the dirt to settle down. Later the same day I added a half dozen adult scouts. And a small bush of dwarf grass goes on the back of the tank. Also I add a subwasser tank and a couple small marima balls. A cutting of hornwort and a cutting of aladia. I always put 2 or more different types of plants in my aquariums. Cover the aquarium to reduce water evaporation. I finish the initial setup on April 15, 2022. With the cover on, the brimless box looks nice. It is already a fully functional aquarium with creatures. Let it sit for bacteria to build up before adding any fish. 4 days later, on April 19th, the water is already crystal clear, looks beautiful. The cover keeps water from evaporating. Oh no! The 3 mm thick plexiglass walls bulged out. The walls of this tank are too thin to hold all the water. Well, the box was designed to be used as a display, not to hold water. Plexiglass for aquariums comes much thicker. So, I have to either disassemble this cube aquarium or... Let's reduce the water level to decrease the water pressure on the walls. I take out 1 liter, leaving 5 liters of water in the cube. On April 26, 11 days after the initial setup, I add young antlers into the cube. One female and three males. The flat walls of the cube offer a much better view for observation purpose than round walls of jars. For this reason alone, this aquarium is going to be shown in my many future videos. The walls of the cube seem to hold the water pressure after I reduce the water volume to 5 liters. I replace the old cover with a wider one to cover the curves of bulged walls. I feed fish 3 times a week. 1-2 times a week with homemade fish food flakes. And 1-2 times with live grindle worms and springtails. Well, it is an addition to the food my antlers find in the aquarium. May 1st. I spotted the first baby fish in the cube aquarium. There is plenty of space for many more fry to come. May 3rd, 2022. I'm setting up a feeder for self-feeding fish in the cube. Springtails and grindle worms are one of the easiest live food to culture. My antlers of all ages enjoy eating them every week. With this feeder, the fish may have springtails every day. And springtails are the perfect snack size live food for baby fish. Let me show to you how adult antlers go after springtails. And here's a view from the top, where you can actually see springtails walking on the surface. And now let's put grindle worms in the feeder as well. That is more than enough worms to start a new colony. Grindle worms and springtails coexist peacefully in the same humid environment on land. So, they should be fine breeding right in the feeder. Five days later, on May 9th. Springtails are already settled down on every surface in the feeder. Let's put a couple baby azepods in the feeder. They are the perfect feeding size for my antlers. And now it is a regular feeding time. Today my antlers get to eat grindle worms. Fish loves grindle worms. Grindle worms have very high nutrition value. And the way worms wriggle in water makes them a very attractive target for fish. Okay, that is more than enough for one feeding. Usually I give less food. Overfeeding causes most problems in aquariums. Always be mindful about it. Grindle worms stay alive underwater for about 12 hours. But fish will eat them long before that. June 3rd. Zach from Brooklyn gifted me with 3 beautiful snails. 1 Colombian and 2 colorful pink and blue ramshorn snails. I think they would make a nice addition to my snails population in the cube. Let's drop the new snails into the aquarium. Thank you very much, Zach, for this beautiful gift. The shell of this Colombian snail is already about 2 cm in diameter. Under the right conditions, it could grow 2-3 times larger. That is another ongoing project in my cube aquarium. June 7th. Here you can see about 6 weeks old self-feeding sustainable cube aquarium. The walls are holding the water. The plants have been taking the space as they should. The snails and antlers are fine. The cube aquarium looks great. I will keep you updated. Have fun and happy aquariums!